Hello, this is Miroslav Bajtos from the Lubeck Core team, and today I'd like to talk about data sources in Lubeck 4. As you might know, in the Lubeck CLI version 2.5, we introduced a new data source template version, which simplifies the configuration of data sources and brings everything together in a single TypeScript file. Now, if you created your project before or using an older version of our CLI, you will still have data source config.json files around. And in today's video, I'd like to show you how you can upgrade your data sources to use the new style and get rid of the JSON config files. Let me switch to the Visual Studio Code, and where I have opened our Lubeck 4 example shopping project to show you the process. And before we begin making changes in the code, we need to ensure that we have a Prettier extension installed in Visual Studio Code. This will help us with the migration process, and I will show you how in a minute. So let's check extensions and search for Prettier. There are different Prettier extensions that can be added. I recommend using the version from Sven Petersen, which I believe is the official Prettier extension for Visual Studio Code. Make sure it's installed, and now we can start the work. So let's find for our data source config file. So data source config.json. In this project, we have quite a few of them. Let's pick the MongoDB data source for an example. The first thing we need to do is open the JSON file, then copy the entire content. And then in the Explorer view, we can see there is also a TypeScript file accompanying the config file. And in this TypeScript file, we export a data source class, which is the artifact used by Lubeck 4 runtime. And the JSON config is loaded into a config variable, as you can see on line 8. And what we are going to do is simply change the require statement and put the entire configuration in the file, kind of inlining the data. And here comes the part where Prettier is very useful, because now when I do format document, the Prettier extension will change the code from the JSON style, where everything is using double quotes, to TypeScript style, where property names are not quoted at all and values are using single quotes. A few more things to do. Let's add a visual delimiter between all the imports and our config variable. And then quite often when you are writing integration tests, you need to change the data source configuration used in the test to make it different from the configuration used in production or when the application is running, even in development mode. And to make that possible, we are exporting the config as a static variable, static member of the data source class. So let's go to the data source class source code and add a new static property. Okay, it's redundantly, there are no reasons to change it. And it's called default config false config. And that's it. We have upgraded our data source file to be all encapsulated in a single TypeScript file. The last step to do is get rid of the JSON file, which is no longer needed. So we can delete the file. And just to make sure all works good, we can run the build, build task, build server, and make sure all builds fine. Yep, we are good. That's all for me for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time. Goodbye.